All right, it seems that the Viva on the streets are never going to end, because this is never going to end. This is an update on Bill 105 that just was rushed through the National Assembly. But at the very least, this law went through the National Assembly, unlike the vaccine passports regulations, unlike a lot of other stuff that has been going down for the last 2 years, which did not go through any standard, normal, democratic legislative process. First things first, this is Pudge. A lot of you ask for proof of life because you don't get to see Pudge as often as you get to see Winston. She is alive and well. She's lost a lot of weight, but she's still very heavy. Pudge, you good? She's good. This is a breakdown, Viva on the Street, of Bill 105, and it is a bill to establish a perimeter of COVID-19 protests around certain establishments. I'll read through some of the law. It's very short, by the way. It's actually only 2 pages long. And finally, I guess the fact that it was so short made it easy for the National Assembly to pass this properly, like a democratically elected government does. And by the way, just a side note, National Assembly in French is Assemblée Nationale, and the website is literally the asnat.qc.ca, I believe. One way or the other, it's ASNAT, Assemblée Nationale, but the abbreviated version is quite a fitting description of what government we are dealing with these days. Bill 105, an act to establish a perimeter as relates to protests. And this is in response to protests that were occurring outside hospitals, allegedly interfering with hospital operations, allegedly harassing, intimidating doctors, nurses, patients. I make no comments on any of this. I'm just saying these are what the rationale justifications are. It is in response to this, where the Legault government, who has been ruling with an iron fist of fury for the last 2 years, the supreme leader, who has been imposing edict after edict that has not even gone through the ASNAT, at the very least this time has, to prohibit protesting around certain establishments, hospitals, schools, healthcare facilities, anywhere where they administer COVID-19 tests, but only as relates to protests regarding COVID-19 testing, because there is an exception carved out in this legislation that it does not apply to healthcare workers and other workers protesting for better work conditions, but it applies to anything related to COVID-19, which means that it applies to parents protesting outside of schools for better air quality for their students, for their kids in school. So just let that sink in as to how the François Legault government knows who butters his political bread, so to speak. The unions and the workers carry more political weight than parents of kids. So naturally, an exception is carved into this piece of legislation that grants an exception to workers who want to protest outside these very same facilities for better working conditions, but it doesn't apply to parents who want to protest outside these facilities for better air conditions for their kids. Let that sink in. Let that sink in. From thesuburban.com, under the bill, parents are prohibited from holding a protest for better ventilation in their children's schools because the matter is related to COVID-19. The nature of this law, pretty straightforward. It says that nobody can protest within 50-meter perimeter of these areas, hospitals, COVID testing facilities, schools, etc. If they do, there is a fine of up to $1,000 to $6,000 fine for inciting people to do it. It's a fine from $2,000 to $12,000. And apparently the fines can be doubled for repeat offenders. No one may be less than 50 meters from the grounds of the following places in order to demonstrate in any manner in connection with health measures ordered under Section 123 of the Public Health Act, COVID-19 vaccination, or any other recommendation issued by public health authorities in relation to the COVID-19 pandemic. Anyone who contravenes the provisions of Section 1 or 2 commits an offense and is liable to a fine of $1,000 to $6,000. Anyone who, in connection with public health measures ordered under Section 123 of the Public Health Act, COVID-19 vaccination, or any other recommendation issued by public health authorities in relation to the COVID-19 pandemic, threatens or intimidates a person who is going to, trying to access, or leaving a place referred to in Section 1, commits an offense and is liable to a fine of $2,000 to $12,000. The issues with this law? Timing. It's quite interesting that this law comes into effect at the very same time that the François Legault government is about to fire a lot of healthcare workers for not being vaccinated. So the question is going to be, for those healthcare workers who want to protest because they have been fired for not being vaccinated, does that fall within the ambit of workplace conditions or COVID-19 protests? In which case, would those employees be allowed to protest or subject to this Bill 105? To be determined, but the timing is interesting. Another interesting thing about the timing. No, you stop that. Stop that. Get over here. Another interesting thing about the timing. It's in the forward explanation of this law. Don't worry about it. This law is not going to be forever. It's only going to be for as long as this health crisis exists. It will end when the health crisis has been declared ended. Lastly, the provisions of the bill will cease to have effect when the public health emergency declared on March 13, 2020 ends. The health crisis that was declared in March 2020. And so you have now 2 years into this health crisis, nearing 2 years. Don't want to be unfair. The government now imposing restrictions on people's right to protest, the constitutional right to protest. This particular bill did not invoke the notwithstanding clause, so we'll see whether or not it withstands constitutional scrutiny. And everybody knows my position on protesting outside of hospitals. I don't think you should do it regardless. But I don't think the government should be coming in with laws to prohibit it. Why? I would argue that laws already exist to prohibit causing a public disturbance. There are already articles in the criminal code that would seemingly cover whatever would be criminally objectionable about protesting or interfering with hospitals or the operations of hospitals, such that you don't need an additional law to cover this. Now, there was, I think it wasn't Cicero, I forget who it was, an ancient Greek philosopher said, more laws, less justice, and this is just another example of it. You have the Legault government, at the very least, this time, going through the National Assembly to pass this Bill 105, and it passed after a very minimal amount of debate, because who would oppose such a thing? Prohibiting protest outside of hospitals and certain facilities, it's a very easy law to pass because it's a very difficult act to defend against. Although I would suggest that there were already laws to prohibit this particular conduct. And it comes at a time which is politically convenient. It comes as a rushed through piece of legislation which highlights the fact that a lot of other edicts that have been imposed by this government under the pretext and guise of the health emergency can be difficult to justify. If they could pass this law quite literally within a week, overnight, they could pass the laws for vaccine passports after a similar debate, except maybe the debate wouldn't quite go as unanimously as this did. But the timing is peculiar, and it is just another example of the François Legault government basically thumbing his nose, if not another finger, at our fundamental constitutional rights. And at the time this goes down, a lot of the Anglo community in Montreal, Quebec, complaining about Bill 96, the bill to amend Bill 101, language laws, etc. And a lot of Anglo saying, what about our linguistic rights? To which I often respond, you have spent the last 2 years forfeiting your most fundamental rights, mobility rights, the rights not to be unlawfully detained. Name them. You have spent the last 2 years forfeiting your most basic fundamental constitutional rights to the government. You thought he was going to stop at your linguistic rights, and now you thought he was going to stop at your rights to protest. I don't think people should be protesting outside hospitals, but I don't think the government should be out there outlawing protest under certain locations with heavy-handed penalties. The law also provides that the courts can issue injunctions to prohibit the conduct outlined in this Bill 105. A judge of the Superior Court may grant an injunction to prevent any act prohibited by Section 1 or 2. Hey, spoiler alert, you didn't need to provide for that by law either. The courts always have the authority to issue injunctions. It's one of the inherent powers of the courts. So the government coming in and saying, we're going to pass a law that gives the courts the rights and powers that they already have, great. More laws, less justice. All you've done is basically outlawed protest outside certain facilities. And you think it's going to stop there? You think it's going to end when this public health emergency is ended? Prediction, it's not. Inasmuch as we had 5 months of a one-month curfew to flatten the curve in 20, what was it, a year into the virus? this is going to be around for a long time. That is my prediction. With that said, holy cow, I tell you, this dog lost a lot of weight, but she's still very healthy, but she's doing good. With that said, if you like my videos, if you like my content, you know what to do. Don't lose faith though, and keep up the fight. Peace.